How Ha Sings the Blues. When I was a kid, around 14 or 15, I was in my parents' basement in the summer trying to bench press a measly 50 pounds when a new video came on BET. I never put the weight locks on, so when I heard what I considered trash at the time, one arm gave in, tilting the bar to the right as a 25-pound weight slid off and ran into the wall. My mother screamed down from the kitchen, "Derek! What was that?" I was appalled. It was the official video for what became a breakout hit, Ha, by the rapper Juvenile. I was used to a different kind of MC. I was tuned into the type that was influenced by the likes of Rakim and Kool G Rap. I was used to the powerful delivery of KRS-One, the cadence of OC, or the smooth and monotone voice of Guru. To me, Juvenile's sound was foreign to my ears. A kid who had grown up in the golden era of hip-hop, creative wordplay and thought-provoking lyrics over boom-bap beats, I thought Juvenile couldn't rap. How wrong I was, thinking back now. Here I am in my late 30s, and I can hear the influences of the blues in his music. Watching the Howlin' Wolf story recently, a documentary about the great blues musician, then shortly thereafter hearing Ha by Juvenile got me thinking about how connected their music really is. Howlin' Wolf was born in Mississippi during the terrifying Nadir period when thousands of black Americans were lynched by racist mobs decades before the Civil Rights era. In adulthood, he moved to Chicago. On the other hand, Juvenile is a Cash Money Millionaires rapper from New Orleans. On the surface, there appears a picture showing two different experiences. But if you look a little closer, you'll find hues and colors that make those experiences share much in common. To hear Howlin' Wolf, a.k.a. Chester Burnett, tell it in Howlin' Wolf's story from 2003, directed by Don McGlynn, quote, "I'm going to tell you what the blues is. When you ain't got no money, you got the blues.
You got the blues. When you ain't got no money to pay your house rent, you still got the blues. A lot of people holler about, I don't lack no blues, but when you ain't got no money and can't pay your house rent and can't buy you no food, you damn sure got the blues. If you ain't got no money, you got the blues, cause you're thinking evil."
On Ha, Juvenile's lyricism meets the Wolf's definition. He's thinking evil as he raps in second person.
You full of that diesel, huh? You ducking them people, huh? Your face was on the news last night, huh?
But on the hook, he evolves from one of the traditions of blues music, that of expressing one's grief, howling about having the blues, to not letting the factors that lead to the blues hold you back. In much the same way that Howlin' Wolf explains what it means to have the blues, Juvenile's Ha speaks to the same mood. "When you ain't got no money, you got the blues," says Howlin' Wolf, while Juvenile raps, "You gotta go to court, huh?" On Howlin' Wolf's track, Backdoor Man, Howlin' is talking about sleeping with another man's woman and sneaking out in the morning. The story shares a lot in common with the kind of sleeping around that Juvenile talks about in Ha.
That's you with that badass business, huh? That's you that can't keep old lady because you keep fucking the friends, huh? You gotta go to...
Juvenile's personal life reflects the soul of the blues, a musical genre rooted in the hearts, minds, and spirits of the descendants of African slaves. He's had legal troubles and personal tragedies, including the murder of his 4-year-old daughter. Though I've never listened to much of his catalog, my research into this connection has piqued my interest. I can remember in the wake of Hurricane Katrina catching his video for Get Your Hustle On from 2006 that was released shortly after. The video opens with the message, "This is a tribute to those who died in the wrath of Hurricane Katrina. The storm may have passed, but for thousands, the struggle is just beginning." The video goes on to spotlight a neighborhood where homes were destroyed and cars turned over, where crosses adorned with framed pictures cover makeshift gravesites like the scene of fatal accidents, while face masks of President George W. Bush, Vice President Dick Cheney, and the mayor of New Orleans at the time, Ray Nagin, are worn by young black kids. As one of the boys turns a mask over to put it on, the words, "Help is coming," are printed on the inside. As history shows for many, help never came, or at best came too late. The attitude and point of the song is, no one is going to save you. Your federal government failed you. It always will. Get your hustle on.
Talk to him. Your mayor ain't your friend. He's an enemy. Just to get your vote, a saint is what he pretend to be. Listen to me, man. Everybody need a check from FEMA. So he can go and score him some cocaine.
Get money.
And I ain't got a ball in the FEMA. Man, I'm trying to live. I lost it all in Katrina. Rock with it, roll with it. You really feeling your folks. Just them crackers behind them vessels that ain't hearing us though.
We starving.
We living like Haiti without no government. Took them killers, niggas, and them bitches is loving it. Fox News, I don't listen to y'all. Couldn't get a motion off the roof of the storm pass.
Talking.
Y'all comfortable right now to your own plan. You can catch it down bad, starving in more cash.
The song and video reminds me of the award-winning documentary that I only recently watched this past February in honor of Black History Month, Trouble the Water. The documentary centers around Kimberly Rivers Roberts and her husband, who filmed herself the day before the storm, as well as the morning that it hits. She's eventually forced to the attic of her home. She continues to film after the storm and flooding recedes as she looks for her neighbors in the Ninth Ward, all of them vulnerable, including a man who appears to be an addict that she spotted asleep on the steps of a porch the day before the storm and had woken up to warn about the hurricane. Though she and her husband survived the storm, their neighborhood was never the same, and they eventually relocate, attempting to get help from FEMA. Roughly 80% of the city was flooded after the levees broke. At least 1,800 people died. The way the poor, much of them black Americans, were left without a means of evacuating or immediate help from the government is reminiscent of the aftermath of the end of the Freedmen's Bureau near the end of Reconstruction in 1872, a national tragedy regretted by W.E.B. Du Bois in his seminal work, The Souls of Black Folk, for both its obvious neglect and its costly mismanagement, the same type of criticism that FEMA and the George W. Bush administration rightfully received. Juvenile's hip-hop may not be the sample-based East Coast hip-hop that I grew up on, but his poetry and the root of his music is just as relevant and poignant, and its relationship to the soul and simplicity of the blues, as well as the historical experience and present reality of Black Americans, cannot be overstated. Now you're going to give it a listen, huh?